Hi guys, it's Chris here from Chris's Creative Life.blogspot.ca. I'm just here to give you a kind of overview of my next Chris's Creative Pages workshop that's available. It features the Nevermore line from Close to My Heart. So here we go. The way the workshop is set up, I'm gonna walk you through the supplies that you use to put it together. So the first is the Nevermore paper pack. So all of the paper and cardstock from the paper pack, and then there's additional colonial white cardstock that you'll need for the backgrounds. The Nevermore compliments, which are two sheets of stickers, 6x6 sheets of Halloween theme stickers, and then there's a couple of generic stickers too, the stars and arrows and pennants. Then there are craft shapes and clear shapes on acetate. Then the other product used is the purple shimmer trim to add a little sparkle to the pages. Another new product is the thick twine in Whisper. And then I used the Designer Creation Slate paper bags. You'll see where that comes into play in a few minutes. Okay, first we'll go through the layouts. So the way that I set this workshop up was so that it wasn't just completely Halloween themed. Two layouts are Halloween themed, and then two layouts are just generic. So this is the layout number one, very Halloween themed, with the clear acetate, a spider web up in the corner, and there's more clear acetate on the pages too. Here's layout number two. This one is also Halloween themed. And here you'll see the whisper twine on the to accent some of the photos. And then we switch over to the more generic pages that aren't super Halloween themed. There's no title on here, but you could add a title in easily. You could also make these pages Halloween themed if you had tons and tons of photos. So this is layout number three. I really like that the way the purple shimmer trim adds a little bit of sparkle to the pages. And then layout number four, also a generic layout that you could do anything with. And again, oh, this one's upside down. Sorry about that. There you go. That looks much better. And then because of the smaller size of all the compliments, they're nice to just create and use as little accents along the way. So because this was just four two-page spreads, I wanted to add in a little bit of a bonus. So the bonus project are these special little treat containers. I think they turned out really cute. They're just a little bit something extra special for those special trick-or-treaters in your life. So you just pull off the whisper twine, and inside is the slate, a designer paper bag, and it creates the pockets for the treats. And I have all sorts of different treats in here. It's just to add a little bit extra special touch to some of those gifts along the way. This one has a little bit thicker Tic Tacs, and then the chocolate bar can go up front or in the back. And this one, too, in here, I just included lots of treats and a gift card. So then I wanted to also show you the actual documents that you get when you purchase the workshop. So if you purchase the supplies on my website, I will send you the documents to create the project. So this is obviously just a cover page. Then there are three pages, there's a list of supplies needed, and then I go through step by step how to actually some ticks, trips, ticks, tricks to remember as you're working along. Explain how to actually make the treat bag. Then There are big pages, print pictures of all the layouts. So layout number 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then there's close-ups of the treat bags. Then there's a cutting guide, pretty simple and easy to follow. It tells you at the top which piece of paper it actually shows you, plus the name is printed on top. Goes all the way through. The way that I set this one up too is if you didn't want to add the extra white, the colonial white photo mats on, you just want to use them for standard photos, I grouped those all onto the last couple of pages of the cutting guide. So if you wanted to omit those, you save yourself a few sheets of colonial white paper, 3 to be exact. So anything that, so these are the bases for two treat bags, and then this is a couple of journaling strips, and this is a journaling box that actually is on this layout. And then everything else are photo mats. So if you wanted to omit those and you didn't want to put those down, you just want to use photos, then you can just cut that out. I hope that this answers a couple of questions. If you have any more questions, though, feel free to send me an email or private message me on Facebook. And again, my blog is chriscreativelife.blogspot.ca. Thanks. Bye-bye.